consider ourselves the original district. So anyhow, well, we talked to Linda and we thought, boy, what is Ron love? Ron loves the people that he works with. And so we wanted to give him some memories as we go out. So we had a video put together of memories for Ron. So we're gonna show that.
First Command, getting them squared away and helping them see their financial lives in possibly a slightly different way than they did before they came to visit us. I'll tell you the most impressive thing that I saw, though, from you over the years, and a testament to how much you care about our clients and our mission, was when you announced your retirement. I talked to you briefly. I could see in your eyes and in your voice how serious you were about taking this mission and how much you're going to miss it. So Ron, on behalf of everyone here in the office and my family and my 30 years of being a client, I want to thank you for what you've done for all of our military families. And I'm sure you'll take that into your retirement as well. Fair winds and following seas, my friend.
Years ago, First Command wrote a storm towards a leeward shore. Some abandoned ship, but Ron Testa was at anchor to leeward, assuming the duties of those lost hands. His commission grew to cover the entire Pacific Northwest, which flourished under his leadership. And now Ron retires to enjoy the sunset cruise he made possible for so many clients, advisors, and staff. It will take three district advisors to cover the seas he once patrolled, but Ron trained many leaders in his career. So it is with great satisfaction we can all wish Ron and Linda fair winds and following seas.
I knew it was going to be a pretty special relationship in my first few months. In typical patient New York style, I remember being out asking some of the assistants about an issue I was having with my outlook, and from another area, you took it upon yourself to try to come fix it without me asking. I'm a legend when it comes to carpentry and IT skills, as I would come to find out over the years. And then when I tried to show you the issue with my computer mouse, you demanded to let you have control of the mouse. When I got a little angry and I refuted, I appreciated the love tap. I felt like I just been recommended by the Godfather. The stories about being on the Frog and the Scorpion and WIIFM. It would be weird not hearing those same stories every couple of weeks, not that you ever know me. Of all the sayings and stories, the one that sticks with me the most, that you repeated, and it was kind of your philosophy as far as leading and helping people, is don't be greedy, which I think really translates to care for others as you would care for yourself. Definitely, I will hope that I can look back on my career and heed those words. And I just wanted to thank you for all that you have done for Natalie and I and the boys, along with the countless others that I've seen you help. Kind of as I wanted to wrap this up, I wanted to leave you with a verse I thought for you and Linda. It's Matthew 5:15-16. It says, neither do people light a lamp and put it under a basket. Instead, they set it on a lampstand. It gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that we see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. Ron, thanks for letting your light shine to those of us who have the pleasure of knowing and working with you. I know you and Linda will continue to be in this new season for you. Love you, Ronnie. And P.S., now they can't wait to crush you and we're good friends.
Yo, Ron, Chris here. You know, you're going to be missed. Happy retirement. You know, you've done a lot for me and Team Mueller since I've been here. I really appreciate everything. You know, hopefully I'll still get to go out on your boat and everything, but you know, we've had some great moments. You know, the Navy is the fattest service. There's actually a story about it in the article, so statistically, I'm just saying that one's out there. But I love the Army, the Navy comeback that we have right there, and everything you've done for the team. You are going to be missed, but you know, if you ever need anything, if I could ever help, just reach out to me, and I am waiting for that boat trip.
All right. Hey, Ron, this is Jerry, yeah, the Marine. Yeah, I'm not from the Navy, but remember, it's the next department I'm in. Thanks for the mentorship, graduation, your retirement, and just enjoy life.
Hey, Ron, congratulations on your retirement. You started after me, you retired before me. Come to visit, I know you guys will. And thanks for all the horses' mouths, okay?
Yeah.
Take care. Bye.
I'm just here for support. Hi, Ron. Okay, this is take two. We did a really good one the first time, but didn't record. So just want to send you all the love and aloha from Hawaii. Thank you for being such an amazing leader, inspiration, and mentor to both of us over our years with First Command. You've done so much for the company and all the clients' lives you touched. We wish you the best in retirement, and hopefully just keep on having fun.
Congratulations, Ron. Thank you for everything, especially for housing me for a week. Really appreciated that. I definitely think you've shaped me to who I am today, so can't thank you enough. Congratulations!
Thanks, Ron. All the love.
Hey, Ron. It's Bobby here in Hawaii. Wanted to say happy retirement. Thanks for not giving up on me, getting me through the licensing, and yep, I'm going to be with this company for a long time and make you and Dick French proud, so. Have a good one. Thanks again.
Hey Ron, this is where I went to loving the church days in the pool.
Ron and Linda, from Nicole and I, we want to wish you the best in the next chapter of your life. And we remember sitting across from you at the DA dinner in Aruba. That was the first trip we took with the West Division. And you two made us feel so welcome to that family. I remember sitting across from you and hearing about how you and Lynn actually met. And it was obvious that you were just a great mentor with so much wise advice. And which is why I made you adopt me to mentor me as a DA. I really hope to make you proud with my career here at First Command. Just know you're a rock star and I'm forever in debt to you. I thank you so much for everything, and I wish you the best.
Happy retirement, Ron. I'm super happy for you, and I know you and Lynn are going to have a great time and having fun in retirement. I'm definitely going to miss you a lot around here, and I say that on behalf of everyone else as well. I just want to say thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to work for such a great company, you know, 5 years ago. I'm going to miss the way that you are a leader around the office and in the district, and how you always have every advisor's back. It's awesome, and it's just amazing. I look up to you so much. I'm also going to miss some of my favorite memories with you are just the events we've had, the Mariners games, the barbecues at your house, the different surprise events that we have at the end of the qualifying year, and so much more. So enjoy your retirement, Ron. I'm going to miss you a lot.
Hi, Ron. It's me, Maria, your favorite office manager. Congratulations on your retirement. Just want to thank you for 8 fantastic years. I know I worked for you. I worked for you for 10 years.
Ron and Linda, we love you guys. Wish you all the best in your retirement. Have a great adventure ahead of you. Love you.
Peace out.
Words of friends again.
60 miles an hour? Hey, Ron, did your car slip underneath that truck right there in front of us?
Whoa!
Hi, Ron. I think my favorite memory is probably the time that we did our joint sessions with Dr. Ron Lindsay and his lovely bride. Or it might be pushing really heavy furniture up the stairs in an 88 compliant building.
Thank you, Ron, for always creating a family-friendly work environment.
And please enjoy your retirement.
Hey, Ron, just wanted to say thanks for all the memories. You were with me at the beginning. You were part of the three that hired me back in 2008. You were with me during my transition to the Vancouver office. Now that you're going into retirement, just wanted to say good luck and take a hike.
Super happy for you finally to be able to have this time in your life come tired so you know that you can enjoy the most of your time. You've been awesome. You've been not only my mentor when it comes to being a DA and an advisor to other members as well, but you've been like a dad in a lot of ways from a personal standpoint, the way you've been there and the way you're always listening and empathetic and want to be everything to everybody other than how you do it. We're going to be missing you a ton, but I always know that you're available for a phone call, and I hope that Uncle Mike can continue to help and provide you a semblance of what you did when it comes to our West Division and our DAs and just living in general. And I look forward to hearing what life holds for you in your future in retirement, and Amber and I pass our love to you and look forward to keeping our friendship. Thank you again.
questions, may it be 7 in the morning or 7 p.m., Saturday or on Monday. I really appreciate for always being there with honest feedback. Enjoy retirement, and hopefully you'll still answer the phone.
I can think of several, but they're absolutely inappropriate and I can't share them. think of Bohica, B1, just to name a few. Gosh, I just can't tell you how much we're going to miss you. And, you know, I probably I've got a pin in your ass. Many times, as you've told me. But, you know, honestly, it's, as much as maybe I don't listen, I watch. And and truthfully, you've probably been one of the biggest, most significant influences on my life, especially over the last 10 years. So for that, I just want to say thank you, and we're going to miss you, and all the best going forward. I know you're not far away, and we'll stay in touch. Bye.
As for memories, there are many. Playing golf together, many advisor conferences, playing poker, our trip to Europe, and of course weekends aboard Special Liberty. My favorite time, though, was the advisor conference in San Diego in 1989. The time we spent together then set the stage for a friendship that would last for well over 30 years. Your legacy, having served with distinction in the United States Navy for over 20 years, plus another 30 years with First Command, you have positively influenced the lives of literally thousands of deserving Americans. You are the epitome of the servant leader and will be fondly remembered by all whose lives you have touched, not the least of which has been mine. Please remember, my friend, that wherever I am, you will always be welcome.
You have touched the lives of literally thousands of military families through your distinguished 20-year career in the United States Navy, through your deep involvement with Project Sanctuary, and from your fabulous role as a VA and advisor for 30 years here. In your current role as a district advisor, you've not only been a wise leader to many in the field, but also to those of us in the home office. You've helped us make sure we always do the right thing. For advisors, our clients. They say, Ron, that old dogs can't learn new tricks. When you put the shoulder behind the lone sailor statue on the Jefferson seawall, you actually were ahead of your time bringing us back to our military market. Even though it cost me a lot of money out of my own project, I'm thankful for that leadership.
Retirement. I couldn't be more proud of you and the work that you've done throughout your career, first with the Navy, then with First Command, as an advisor and a district advisor. Your retirement is well deserved, and here I am in our new car, ready to go on a road trip with you. I'm looking forward to spending the rest of our lives together, just enjoying life and one another. I love you, and once again, congratulations on a job well done. Woo!